Good morning, everyone, and very happy Easter to you. We have special hymn sheets for today with the four hymns, numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I'd appreciate it if you could return them at the end of Mass because we'll use them again next week. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Our Lady of Pity. Happy Easter. You'll find the readings today on page 1165B in the hymnal. And please join us in singing our entrance hymn as we welcome Monsignor Gray to say our Mass this morning. It's hymn number 1, Christ the Lord is risen today, number 1.
Praise is free. your only begotten Son have come to earth yet, and are not the cost of captive eternity. Grant, we pray, that we keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection. May through the renewal brought by your Spirit rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea and in Galilee after the baptism of John Christ, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man, God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, "His mercy endures forever." This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but and declare the works of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord as it's been done, it is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloth there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloth there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloth, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scriptures that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Once again, you and your loved ones a very happy Easter. The date was April 18, 1906. The time, 5:13 a.m. The place, San Francisco. You can read all about it in a very well-done book by James D'Alessandro called 1906. It happened, the incident, and we'll get to that in a moment. It happened 3 days after Easter. It happened just hours after a concert by the great opera singer Enrico Caruso. In fact, the paper never made it out, but the early morning paper called it not just a concert, but a revelation. And what happened? San Francisco had one of its worst earthquakes that it ever had had. Some 35,000 buildings were either demolished or even severely damaged. Tens of thousands of trees were uprooted and just thrown around. 2,000 people were injured and or lost their lives. The city was in complete panic. All you could see were emergency lights, all you could hear were emergency sirens. Complete and utter chaos. But then D'Alessandro and his book shifts, and he shifts us to the scene in the hotel. People are running out of the hotel, half dressed in their pajamas on, and they're running towards the pier to get on the boat in order to escape. No one really knew what was happening. But Enrico Caruso is there, and he becomes deathly frightened. All he could think about is that because of all the fire and smoke, that he would no longer be able to sing, and it would affect his throat, his voice. And eventually, his staff was able to convince him that he was still able to sing. So they said to him, "Open the window and sing, and you'll hear that you can still sing." So Caruso does that. He opens the window, and he begins to sing one of the arias from the evening before. And despite all the panic and chaos, despite everything that's going on, people actually stop to listen. And then when he hit the final ending of it, of the aria, the crescendo, actually people applaud it. And no sooner did they do that, they went back to the chaos. But what he said at the end, that crescendo, was really kind of important. If you translate it from the Italian into English, it's this: loss does not wound deeply because it is replaced by hope. Loss does not wound deeply because it is replaced by hope. So why do I bring all this up? Because I think it's a very simple sentence that sums up the entire Easter story. Loss does not wound me deeply because it is replaced by hope. Was there a loss? Oh, there was loss indeed, right? The Mary Magdalene, Simon Peter, the apostles, the larger group of the disciples, they had lost their master. They had lost their teacher. They had lost their rabbi, their miracle worker. They lost the person that for years, 3 years or so, they believed to be the Son of God, to be God himself. Were there wounds? Oh, absolutely. There were physical wounds and there were psychological wounds as well. There was Christ's physical wounds, right? From the scourging at the pillar, from the crowning of thorns, from being nailed to the cross. Then there were their own psychological wounds. The wounds of fear, anxiety, hurt, being betrayed, and let down. But then what happened? What happened is Mary Magdalene and then Simon Peter and the others show up, and the stone is moved back. The stone is moved back because no one is in the tomb except the burial cloths. So all of the loss and all of the wounds, no matter how deep they were replaced. Replaced by hope. That's actually the word that defines the Easter story, one single word. Easter is all about hope. But then, that formula that we're using, that crescendo, loss does not wound me deeply because it is replaced by hope. That's just like in some of the Easter story, but there's a personal level to it as well. There's a personal level to that loss does not wound me deeply, but is replaced by hope. It's this, for those of us who believe, you and me, for those of us who believe in the Easter story, that our own wounds, our own losses, can be replaced by hope, can be replaced by Easter hope, by the risen Jesus hope. In fact, two types of hope. One hope is a common one, and the second one not as common, so we'll spend a little more time on our reflection. But the first hope is the hope for the future. The hope for the future that one day you and I will enjoy the same resurrection that Jesus enjoyed on Easter Sunday. That one day at the end of time, you and I will be called individually by the Lord and resurrected and brought and welcomed into the kingdom of heaven, where we will be with God and with all of our previous loved ones once again. Then it's the less common one, the one that I'd like to focus in on a little bit as well. There's also hope for the here and now. Because you and I can start to enjoy little resurrections. That's the big one. But you and I can start to enjoy little resurrections here and now by Christ's hope, by the Easter hope. Because you see, Easter season, the Easter graces, the risen Jesus gives us what we need to be able to enjoy little resurrections, to be able to move the stone back and free us from whatever it is that's entombing us, maybe spiritually. Whether it be greed or anger or tolerance, whether it be jealousy or an addiction or impatience or despair, you and I allow the risen Lord to bring us his hope. You and I can begin to release ourselves of losses and wounds, even in the here and now, and enjoy little resurrections before the big one. Loss does not mean we deeply because it is replaced by hope. It became the motto for San Francisco as it renews itself. And it works. It works for Enrico Caruso. It works for Mary Magdalene and Simon Peter, when you and I allow it to work for us. In other words, when you and I allow the risen Lord to take away our losses and our wounds and to replace them with hope. With hope that only he can bring. concerned before God as Jesus did.
That the newly baptized and newly received continue their lifelong journey into the paschal mystery, we pray to the Lord. That the living body of Christ gathered here nourish the spirits of those who have received the Easter sacraments, we pray to the Lord. That our Holy Father, Pope Francis, will inspire brilliant faith and encourage Christ-based love for the poor of the world, we pray to the Lord. That leaders throughout the world work to protect the dignity and sanctity of human life from conception through natural death, we pray to the Lord. For all loved ones who have died, that they enter into the joys of eternal life, especially Maria and Severio Campo Reale, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord. In silence, we recall our personal intentions and the intentions of those who have requested or need our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Glorious God, who raised up your Son from the dead, raise us up and hear these our prayers, that we may praise your glory today and always. We ask that as we ask all things, through Jesus Christ, your Son, and our Redeemer.
Amen.
Now, our offertory hymn today is number 2 on the sheet at the Lamb's High in number 2.
Yeah.
communion given today is number 3, All You on Earth.